Now let's bring back in Jeff. And also, let's welcome our special guest, Ed Slott. Ed is a public speaker and is well-versed in IRAs and retirement distribution planning. He's also a practicing CPA and has written 5 books, including the recently revised Retirement Savings Time Bomb and How to Diffuse It. Ed, thanks so much for being back here on The Income Generation.
Great to be back with you.
Ed, it's so great to have you today. On the particular topics we're discussing, we're focusing on estate planning. And every day, David and I hear from folks all across the country who are concerned about not creating a huge estate for their kids, but they would much rather, if you ask them, keep their money in the family versus it going to the IRS. And it's a very simple choice. And so what happens is we amass incredible amounts of wealth in IRAs and 401ks and other pre-tax items. But then what happens when we die, Ed? We have a huge income tax. So tell us what you think some of the best strategies are to keep that money in the family.
Well, here's a simple one. Spend more. All right, done. Spend it all, give to charity. But if your favorite charity, like most people, is your family, then you may have to do some things now. And now is still a great time. 2021, we know what today's tax rates and brackets are. We might not know them for 22. So when you say income tax, that's for most people who have accumulated wealth in taxable, or we should say tax deferred, IRAs and 401ks. That money has not yet been taxed. So if that money gets passed to heirs, that money will be taxed. That money never got a step up in basis. You know, everybody's screaming about the end of step up in basis, if that even happens. I doubt it. But remember, for most people where their largest assets are in tax deferred accounts, that never gets a step up in basis. No matter where it ends up, whether it's your heirs, your children, grandchildren, whatever, they're going to pay an income tax. Now, you can help decrease or reduce that tax hit by, for example, converting to a Roth IRA now. It might cost you some money now, but at least you'll be leaving them tax-free money. Or even better, you might use life insurance. I'm talking about permanent insurance as a planning tool. And just so you know, I know you guys know, but I don't sell insurance, stocks, bonds, funds, annuities, none of that. I'm a tax advisor. But as a tax advisor, after the SECURE Act eliminated the big benefit of IRAs passing to heirs through the stretch IRA, I believe life insurance is the single biggest play to actually exchange bad assets for good assets. IRAs, thanks to the SECURE Act, and that was Congress's intent, have been downgraded as a wealth transfer or estate planning tool. They just don't work anymore with this 10-year rule after death and all the tax bunched into that period. Better off, if that money is intended for heirs, it's better to take those funds down now over the next few years, use up the lower brackets while they last, and then take the after-tax money, put it in a life insurance policy. The beneficiaries will get larger inheritances, more control, and less tax. And that's what everybody wants. They don't care about the vehicle that gets them there. The old IRA vehicle has pooped out. Now you need to switch to a limo.
Sure. Well, you're right, Ed. But when you say, I want to leave an inheritance, it polarizes people. Our viewers, our listeners, they would much rather keep the money in the family than having it go to the government. So maybe we should just say, instead of making it go to the government, here's a way to keep the money in the family. Now, everybody wants to do that because, of course, they value their family more than the IRS does, fortunately.
Well, let me first tell you, you know, if you're leaving money to Uncle Sam, he's not even your real uncle, okay? So that doesn't count as family if that's where you're getting confused. Not a real uncle, not a real thing. Your family can get actually larger inheritances with a couple of items I just recommended and tax-free and not have to worry about all these complex tax rules.
Sure. And, you know, for our viewers and listeners, what Ed's talking about is that you used to be able to have your heirs really take out the IRA money in small little bits and pieces over the course of their lifetime. Now it's all got to be taken out and the taxes have to be paid within 10 years. But Ed, you mentioned the step up in basis. Now, the Biden administration is trying to eliminate the step up in basis, which I call the tax forgiveness of death at death of non-IRA assets. I'd like you to talk about that for a minute, because that's going to affect a lot of average Americans more than they realize.
Right. This is why it has never passed I don't know if anybody realizes this, but I did some research on this. The Step Up in Basis is celebrating, if you want to call it that, its 100th anniversary this year. It came into the tax code in 1921, 100 years ago. And then throughout that time, whenever there was a war or financial trouble or other crises, you know, get the rich, they always said, get rid of that Step Up in Basis. It's for rich people. And every proposal, like they're talking about now, never, ever passed, because when they got down to it, they realized it would fall on all the wrong people, homeowners and small business owners.
So what do you think, Ed? Do you think it won't pass this time, or do you think?
I don't think so. I think it's too much of a shock to the system. Once it starts hitting the real estate market and small businesses and businesses that have lots of, first of all, it's very hard for a small business, a family business, let's say, even with Step Up in Basis, to pass to the next generation. You know, these things don't last that long. But to force the next generation to pay a tax on money that's not there, it's invested in land, property, plant, equipment, all of these things, there's no money for that. That would end businesses. Even with the proposed $1 million exemption, it would create all kinds. It's too much of a shock to the system, especially, in my opinion, especially with a 50-50 Senate. Anything that out of whack is never going to pass. It's too. It's going to affect all the wrong people.
I hope you're right. Unfortunately, we all know that dead people don't vote, and we're going more and more left politically, so you never know what's going to happen. But hopefully people will be able to pass their beach homes and things like that on to their children.
Yeah, but dead
without
people
worrying
still
about
have real estate.
So, yeah. So, Ed, thanks so much. Unfortunately, we need to leave it there for now. Really appreciate you being back on the show. It's been great. And coming up after the break, we're going to talk more about the importance of wills and trusts and how to start the estate planning process, because it's easier than you think. I'm Dave Scranton. We're the Income Generation. Stick around. We'll be right back.